All right, so it is Sunday. I don't have on my Fitbit. So it is Sunday, It is currently Sunday, March 3rd. I'm headed to the hospital again. But before that, I'm taking my mom's car because my car finally just gave out and it's stuck on the side of the road. So I'm gonna get that towed to a shop. And last night I had some trouble. My geese run, I tell you, they only come out when I film. But last night when I was using my mom's car, because it hadn't been used in 2 months, it died. So I had a lot of issues with cars in this past 2 days. So I'm gonna go get that car towed. I'm gonna take her car up and meet her up in Baltimore at the hospital. So as you can see behind me, I'm finally getting my car towed off the side of the road while I wait with my mother's car. It's a long morning. It's a long, long morning. So just watch that my tire does not move as he pulls it. Lovely. Can y'all see the white on the ground from where it's dragging? All right, so my car is off to another city and another county to hopefully get fixed, and I am on my way to the hospital. So my car and I are going in two separate directions. It's been a great day. Bye-bye, baby. Be safe. Now I'm off to the hospital. Bye, car. I don't know if you all heard in that last clip or the last couple of clips, my rear tire locked up, the brakes froze or seized or whatever you want to call it. So that back wheel, which was significantly rusted, as you also saw, just was dragging. It was just dragging along. So yeah, hopefully that can get fixed. So I'm going one direction, my car is going the other direction. Morning, loves. So as you saw and as you can see, it's been a very, very long morning. Does this help with the light? Hold on. Is that a little better? I don't know. So I just got my car towed, as you saw in the previous clips, and now I'm on my way to the hospital. So if you haven't caught up with me, it's been a long time since I did a vlog. I did make two like catch up with me life update videos. So if you want to check those out, I will be linking them in the cards above with a little I as well. Well, it'll be on this side. As well as I'll put them in the end screen as well. But basically, I just had a lot going on lately, and it's been really hard to just be my happy self. I'm headed to Baltimore to go to Johns Hopkins. That is the hospital mom is currently at. And like I said, I haven't done a vlog in quite some time. So today I'm gonna be vlogging. I'm gonna vlog going in the hospital, seeing her. You guys are gonna come along with me for that. As you saw, you guys gotta come along with me as I got my poor baby toad. I'm currently in my mom's car, cleaned it up real nice for her, vacuumed the interior, wiped everything down, organized it. So I wanted to do that for her, especially if she's able to drive again, which I'm not sure that'll be anytime soon. But you know, just in case, it'll be nice to have a clean car to come home to. I've been dealing with a lot of stuff in my life, all areas of my life. Literally, there's right now not really an area that's not causing me stress or pain or just something. I'm struggling to find peace right now. I don't know how to adjust it for this car. So I will link those videos above. They are long. One's like 30 minutes and one's an hour, but I had a lot to say. I had a lot to update you guys on. So I would recommend you grab a snack and you go check out those videos and just catch up on what's been going on with Dominique. Why hasn't she been vlogging? Like, where is she? Because, you know, I was pretty consistent with putting my videos up, but those videos will explain why I kind of took a step back, and there's a lot. But let me tell y'all, this car last night caused me its own set of stress. So I went to my mom slash grandmother's house to go get this car and to get up some of my mail that got sent there. And I was like, oh, okay, let me vacuum out the interior, because I spent some time, I cleaned the car out while I was at the house, and I was like, oh, let me go down the street to the gas station to vacuum it. And I was like, it'll be perfect because she needs gas too. I'm gonna need gas to get up to Baltimore. So I'll just, you know, one-stop shop, get gas, vacuum, have a clean car, be ready to go. We knew it wasn't gonna be that easy. Get to the gas station. Vacuuming the car, going about my business, blah, blah, blah. Ooh, look, it looks real nice and clean. Ooh, I'm so impressed. I go to turn on the car so I can go to the gas pump. Car didn't start. The car did not start. You heard that correctly. So I was like, okay, well maybe it was only a little bit of gas and it ran out of gas. So I went inside the gas station. Luckily I had my wallet and my money and all that stuff on me. Went into the gas station and was like, do you guys have one of those little like gas cans? Luckily they had one, so I bought it. This stupid little 1 gallon gas tank cost me $12. For 1 gallon. I was like, it's okay though. Bought it, asked for 1 gallon of gas on pump two. This fool charged me $20. Sir, I said, I want 1 gallon of gas. Where are you expecting the other gallons to go? Are they just gonna overflow? Am I gonna pause and come back to it? Like, I asked for 1 gallon of gas for a reason, because I have a 1 gallon gas thingamabob. What are those things called? Like, hello, give me my money back. He gives me my money back, and then I put the gas in the car. It took me 10 minutes to figure out the little thing, how to get the gas to come back out. That's I don't even feel like talking about that. So I get the gas in the car, still doesn't turn on. I'm like, okay, well maybe it needs a little bit more gas just for the car to register that I filled it up. Well, put something in it and then it can start up. Go and buy a 2nd gallon of gas, fill it up, put it in the car. Car still doesn't turn on. So at this point I'm like, well, it's very obvious that it's not the gas that is the problem. But at least I have gas in the tank because I needed some anyway. Now, thank God we have AAA. So I put it on my app for roadside assistance and was like, hey guys, I need the car jumped. So as I should have assumed, the car hadn't been used in 2, possibly a little bit more than that, months. So the battery basically was drained. So when a car sits idle and it has been turned on or used and charged up, that battery drains out naturally. So I had to get a jump and he was like, just keep it on for 30 minutes. And luckily I was not in my county. I had to drive back to my house. So by the time I got home, it had been on. So that was that. That was really fun. And it was very cold because it was cold last night and no car means no heat. So yeah. But the car is on now, as you can see, it's filled with gas, and I'm on my way. As I'm driving, I'm kind of laughing, like even something simple like that. So in one of my previous videos, I let you guys know that I have like specialty tires, is what they like to term, the term they like to use. Basically all that means is my rim to wheel ratio is a little bit different than normal cars. So I have a little bit more rim, not like a significant difference, but my rims are a little bit larger than the standard size rims. So the gap between the rim and the road, meaning like how much tire is separating the rim and the road, is a lot less. So when I hit bumps or potholes, like it's drastic, it's very loud, it's very dramatic. So I've had to put a couple new tires on this car due to flats, because where I live, potholes don't get filled quickly and they are large in number. So I'm driving my mom's car and it's just smooth sailing. I'm hitting bumps like it's nothing. We're just rolling over stuff. It's crazy how like 1 inch difference of tire can be that drastic. Welcome to Baltimore. This is the Inner Harbor. This is where most tourists go. It's where like the aquarium and all those things are. We have arrived. John Hopkins Hospital. I am quite proud of myself. I just backed this car in with no backup cameras. And yes, I know that probably sounded super bougie, but when that's all you've been used to for years, that's all I know. So I'm here with my mom. Got my lovely getup on. You wanna say hi? Or wave? I'm sorry. So it's a rough day for mommy. She's having trouble breathing. You wanna say good morning? Aww. Obviously I'm gonna hang out with her for a little bit. I will catch back with you guys later. Mommy just got her sponge bath and her lotion. And we're waiting on her lunch. She got fancy today and ordered a chicken quesadilla with all the fixin' on the side and a Lorna Doone. And she'll probably eat one bite and then be like, meh, I don't want any more. So that's been the trend lately. Her mind has an appetite, but her body right now just doesn't. But we're hoping that she likes it. That Cali side came out. She wanted something Mexican. So we'll see. It'll probably be here in an hour because it takes quite a while for it to be prepared and brought over. So mom's lunch arrived. She got a quesadilla with all the fixings. Hopefully she's able to eat it. How is it? Think you'll be able to eat it? Okay. My mom just terrified me because she like looks and her eyes get wide and she points at the window and I'm thinking like some bird or something is flying towards the window and I'm about to die. It started to snow. Probably can't even see it on camera. I'll see if I can change the angle. Hold on. So it's ever so slightly flurrying, but you have to remember my mom hasn't been able to really look out the window when she's been at home. So when was the last time you saw snow? It's been a while, hasn't it? It's been a good while since she's seen snow, and it's definitely snowed a couple of times. So yay, you're gonna see your first snow, mommy. Yay! You wanna update them on your bruising? I haven't shown them. I'm gonna put your other clips in another video. So I said you wanna show them your bruising? This is gonna be a vlog today. So she's pretty bruised up. Don't worry, no one's been fighting her. It's just her body's been poked and prodded and it's trying to heal. My little concussion. You're colored after all. And she's watching some Fixer Upper. I brought her some stuff, some socks and slippers her mom got her, and some snacks that she probably won't eat, and a brush, and yeah. Okay. She's right behind you.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Good job. So she had to sit back down to catch her breath, but she made it from the bed all the way out the door. But she started feeling a little bit of pain, but she's sitting back down doing some leg movements. Killed it, mama. Yeah. So I just got super excited because they have nugget ice and it's yummy. Anybody else like to chew ice? And yes, I know that chewing ice is not good for you, but it's delicious. So whatever, it's worth the risk. So I'm hanging out here. I'm probably gonna head home in probably an hour. I'm wet. An hour or so because the snow is trying to stick a little bit. So I'm sure once the sun goes down and the temperature drops, it's definitely gonna stick a little bit more. But yeah, I'm proud of my mom today. She walked. She ate more food than I've seen her eat this entire time. She's been drinking and taking all her meds and doing everything. She's such an inspiration. She's my Shiro. I just want you guys to see the reaction when I said, she's my Shiro. Did you like that? Alright guys, so I'm gonna start heading home because the sun is going down. Time to say bye to mommy for the night. Bye! We'll see you next time. I'll catch you guys when I'm in the ride home. It's never easy leaving. It always makes me sad. Hmm. Alright guys, so I'm back home, but I realized I never had actually updated you. I gave an update in the documentary footage, but I never gave an update in the vlog footage today. So, just an update for you guys, those who are keeping track and have been watching my update videos. My mom was diagnosed with cancer. Right now they're just labeling it as MDS, which is a form of blood cancer. It's pre-leukemia, but they're still not ruling out full leukemia. They're still waiting on a couple tests to come back. So even though it's disheartening, my mom has cancer, her and I are both kind of comforted in the fact that we know now. So does that make sense? Like, we know what's going on, so now we know our next steps, we know what to prepare mentally for, and we can go from there. And then in addition to her having leukemia, she also is suffering right now. There's like a little hair. She's suffering right now from the flu, pneumonia, an infection, and thrush. So she's going through it right now. Her body is just taking her every which way it can. It's pushing her limits. So we've had a couple of scary moments this week. It's definitely been intense, but she is a fighter. She's strong. Almost dropped y'all. As you saw in the footage today, she's still witty. Today she was having a little bit of trouble with her breathing, which is why she was not talking much. In the other footage that I've taken in previous days, she'll talk your ear off. She was very funny, but she just has a lot of mucus build up from the pneumonia and stuff like that, that it's kind of around her vocal cords, so it's hard for her to talk. But before I left, she did ask me to say thank you to all of you who have been leaving kind words below in the comments or on Facebook. Especially thank you so much to those who have donated to her fundraiser campaign on Facebook. I'll leave the link for that down below. I'm just trying to raise money for her medical bills, just to kind of help her out. She hasn't been to work in 2 months, so it's just a lot. So thank you so, so much to everyone who has chipped in and donated some money to that. Every little bit counts, it adds up. So thank you from the bottom of our hearts. I'm gonna wrap this video up here so I can edit it. It'll either be up today, which is Sunday, or tomorrow, which is Monday. It all just kind of depends on how tired I am and how quickly these videos upload, as well as how long it takes on YouTube. So we'll see. Until next time, I love you guys. Bye. Mwah.